matching today. Matching from a center point, matching elbows, and matching shoulders. So when we're matching a center point, it's as if we have a pole that slides down their two hands and stays here. So they can stretch away from this pole if they stretch their bodies away, or they can stretch towards the pole as long as this pole stays right in between them. Another way to think about it is that no matter where your hands are, they should be equal distance between both partners. So let's then go to elbow matching. We're going to just demonstrate with two hands for this one. So with elbow matching, this is a concept that we really want follows to be thinking about. So if Stephen decides he's going to stretch all the way out with his elbows, Andrea's going to match her elbows and make the exact same shape. And as he bends them, the more he bends them, she's going to match the same bend and the same shape in the elbow. With shoulders, anytime Stephen is straight on, Andrea's going to make sure that she's right in front of Stephen and her shoulders are nice and square with his. So in other words, if Stephen was here, Andrea wouldn't just open up her body to the left like this. That would not be following or matching. She's going to stay right on. And then if Stephen decided to do a little walk in a circle here, Andrea is always going to be sure that she's right in front of him with those shoulders and not twisted one direction more than the other direction. Now, if Stephen decides he's going to twist one way, he'll open up, and then she follows him. And if he goes the other way, she'll match that as well. We're going to start with the concept of matching a center point. So sometimes that means we're going to stretch away from a center point, and sometimes it means we're going to compress into a center point. We're going to start with a cross hand side pass that we've already learned. And if you watch really closely on the hands, what we want to make sure is that they're always equal distance between the partners. So here we go. We have our cross hand side pass. We have a rock step and pass, and a rock step and pass, and a rock step and pass. Good. We're going to take that same type of move and do our butterfly side pass with our kick at the beginning. So our one exception to our center point here is going to be this lift up. If you remember on the butterfly, Brian has to take Andre a little off balance. Now when he goes into the rock step, they're going to make sure that hand comes to the center, and she's going to stretch away from that center point as much as she feels to keep these hands in the center. We ready for our butterfly? So we're going to go our kick up and a rock step, pass, by. We're going to keep those hands in the center, pass, by. We're going to take two Charleston moves and show the center point for those. We're going to use our kick away Charleston and our pancake Charleston. So we have a hand connected here in front of our partners. And so Brian, as he kicks away, Andrea is also going to do her part to make sure these hands stay in the center, even though they're going to be rotating and moving where that hand connection is. It's always going to stay equal distance between them. So here we go. Here's our kick away Charleston. Kick and a kick, kick and a kick, kick and a kick, kick and a kick. So we're going to make sure that hand stays equal distance between the partners. Now if we transition now to pancake Charleston, we're going to go right to right. So go ahead and switch to our right hands. And then same thing here. We want to make sure this hand stays equal distance between the partners. And on this one in particular, we want to keep a nice and steady handhold for our center point. We don't want to let it move back and forth. So when we're doing pancake Charleston, this is a good time to practice compressing. And that compression is going to allow us to keep that hand right in between. Okay, so we're going to kick those right legs first. We have kick and kick, kick and kick. Good, and you can see they're keeping those hands nice and steady, and not letting them push one way or the other. We don't want the leader to let the hand push forward or the follow to let the hand push away from her. Let's demonstrate our concept of a center point with two moves that use compression. The first one is lolly kicks, and then we're going to do a tuck turn. Both have a similar type of connection. So if we do our lolly kicks, we're going to go ahead and do a hand hold hand to hand here. And we can do this Lindy hop type handhold, or we can demonstrate the other one like this. Either handhold that you choose is fine. We just want to make sure that that handhold becomes our center point, whether we're stretching away from it or compressing into it. So they're going to demonstrate the ground step here. You're going to keep these hands in the middle, so go ahead and rock away. Now, as they come in for the first kick, they're going to keep these hands nice and steady, so go up for that kick, and they keep that hand in the exact same place, so it becomes a center point for them to stretch and compress away from. So let's go ahead and do our lolly kicks, and we're going to keep that hand nice and still in the middle. Here we go, and a rock step, a kick, a stretch, compress, stretch, compress. With a tuck turn, we have the same concept. We have this hand connection in the middle, and you can choose this hand hold or the hand-to-hand, whichever you prefer. They're going to stretch away from that hand hold on their round rock step, and then come in for a compression for the tuck turn. And this will be the same technique whether we're doing a triple step for a tuck turn or our Charleston footwork for the tuck turn. So here we go, we're going to do a six count tuck turn and demonstrate this hands in the middle or center point. Here we go, and rock step, a kick step, and kick step. Okay, so we're going to kick those right legs first. We have kick and kick, kick and kick. Good, and you can see they're keeping those hands nice and steady and not letting them push one way or the other. We don't want the leader to let the hand push forward or the follow to let the hand push away from her. Good, so let's stop right there, and we're going to show a couple examples of things that we see sometimes with pancake Charleston that are incorrect matching. So if Brian and Andre go right to right, sometimes we see the leader push the follow's hand this way, and the follow lets her arm relax and just lets it get pushed. So we want to make sure the follows are matching, so when they feel a push against their hand, they're going to push back. There we go. So we want to make sure we don't see that in our pancake Charleston especially. We're going to do a simple six count underarm pass with triple steps. And even on this turn, the hands will always stay in between the partners at an equal distance. So here we go, our six count underarm pass. We're going to make sure it stays here. And then in between the partners, even as we turn around. So let's do a couple in a row. Here we go, a rock, a triple, and it stays between triple, triple. Our next concept is elbow matching. Simply elbow matching, if we're here, the elbows should match on both sides for the leader and the follower. And if they come out straight or if they're bent, it should look the same. This is a concept that really is for follows, and that will make them use the same amount of energy that the leader is using. If he comes in fast with the elbow and she matches, we'll get a little more momentum in some of our movements, or maybe a little more stretch out. So we're gonna start with a very simple basic move, our side to side with Lindy hop footwork. And this is a great one to practice varying degrees of stretching out or keeping the elbows tight. So here we go, we're gonna do our side to side, a rock and a triple, a rock and a triple. So you can see Steven's choosing a nice long stretch out on his rock steps, and Andrea's matching it. And then when he comes in, he's bringing the elbows more of a square position. All right, so now we're gonna try a tight rock step. So Steven's gonna keep the elbows tight when he rocks. Here we go. A rock, a triple, a rock. So he's not allowing very much stretch here for Andrea, and she's matching it really nicely. And I think we prefer a little more give on that stretch. So let's go back to stretch. And the last one we wanna practice is on our triple steps, letting those arms come down. So we're gonna let the hands fall. We're gonna stretch out and let the hands fall and see if we match that one. Here we go, rock and let them down, rock and let them down, rock, let them down, good. So three ways to practice that side to side to get a good handle on our elbow matching. The boomerang is a great one to practice elbow matching for the follow. Because leaders often will do this boomerang at different intensities. And different intensity means the elbows come in quickly or the elbows come in a little bit slowly. So it's a great way for the follow to practice matching that elbow precisely. So here we go. We're going to do our boomerang with two hands. And Andrea is going to match whatever Stephen does with the elbows. Here's the boomerang. Rock, triple. We're going to match the elbows on the way out. Good. So Stephen chose a pretty close shape for his elbow on the side. So now we're going to do the boomerang again, and this time when he finishes the boomerang, he's going to let it stretch out a little bit more. Here we go. And rock, triple, and he's going to let that elbow release a little bit more. So you can see now almost a So here we are, and a rock, step, triple step, 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 triple step. Good, we kept that hand at equal distance through that 8-count underarm pass. We're gonna do a little more elbow matching with some Charleston side passes and variations on the side pass. So here's another way for Andrea to watch Brian as he does these rock steps, and she's gonna match her elbow with what he does. So Brian's gonna do his rock step. We're gonna keep those hands and the elbows the same, and as they reconnect, she has to pay attention to how much he's gonna do. So Brian, let's go ahead and transition now to a tight rock step. And Andrea's gonna keep her elbow in when he keeps his elbow in, and that makes for a very different feel. Let's take that same Charleston side pass and turn it into a butterfly. The butterfly has that raise up at the beginning, but then when you go into that rock step, the follow has to pay close attention to how much he wants on that stretch and match the elbows. Here we go, we have our butterfly and our stretch and kick. And then they reconnect and we start all over. And let's do a tight rock step on this next one. An up and a tight. Good. All right. Our last matching concept is shoulder matching. Now remember, as a follow, our job is to match where the leader is. So if he straightens up, I want to stay right in front of him. And if he decides to twist, I'm going to match those shoulders. Or if he opens, I'm going to match. Or closes, I'm going to match. So Brian and Andrea are going to do our he goes, she goes, Lindy hop move. And as he puts Andrea in front or himself in front, Andrea's going to make sure that she's matching those shoulders and that they stay nice and square. So here's our he goes, she goes, rock step, triple, and the shoulders match up. And as he puts her in front, those shoulders match up again. We're going to take our triple swing basic step in closed position. This is just our 6-count triple swing. And this one is really great for shoulder matching. It's one of the few moves that we can put in our Lindy hop that let the shoulders go up and down. A majority of our moves are going to stay level with the shoulders. So this is a good one to practice for the follows, to watch those shoulders and stay even. So here we go, as we do our first triple, we're gonna lean forward, and that second triple is gonna lean back. And you can see Brian and Andrea get a really great pike in their legs to keep that triple swing just as it should be. This is great technique here. Our next one to practice shoulder matching, we're gonna do a 6-count send out with triple steps. This is one I see often done wrong for the follows. As he sends the follow out, a lot of times we'll see the follow open up too much. So go ahead and demonstrate it the wrong way. So we're gonna do our rock step, triple, and a lot of times we see the follow open up like this, even though the leader is straight. So to practice shoulder matching here, Andrea would shift in and make sure she's matching Brian. Now, if Brian chose to open up at the end of his send out, if he decided to do his send out over here, then Andrea would also open up, and we could get some really cool moves by doing something like this. But the important thing is that we match. So let's bring Andrea back in here, and we'll do it the right way. Here's our 6-count send out. She's gonna look for his shoulders as she comes out, and they're both staying square on the send out. Mark and I discussed in another lesson the sugar push. This is a perfect one for practicing shoulder matching. Andrea comes in with him, and then back to square. And this is another one of those moves that we see the follows match wrong, where the follow will open up too much here. And if the leader is not opening up, we wanna make sure that we match the shoulders. So Steven's coming back to square on his sugar push. In that same lesson, Mark and I taught the sugar push and then our Lindy hop hand passes. Now on the hand passes, the leader is going to open up. So let's do those here. We have our front. And you can see Steven opens up on both sides, and Andrea is matching the shoulders both directions. This one's really nice to pair with the sugar push, because the sugar push is gonna go back to square position, and this one continues to open. We're gonna demonstrate a pattern for practicing a center point, and of course we can focus on other types of matching in this pattern, but we're gonna really focus on a center point for these set of moves. So Brian and I are going to start in side by side and go going to our kickaway Charleston and our pancake Charleston and really focus on keeping those hands equal distance from each other. We'll start in side-by-side position and we're gonna do a couple Charleston basics and get a feel for that hand connection in the front. And then Brian's gonna transition to kickaway Charleston and we're gonna focus on keeping that hand equal distance between us. Now the hand connection is a little bit different when we transition to pancake Charleston. We're gonna keep that hand right in between us and right in between our hips and use that as a point for turning. And then Brian's gonna go back into our kickaway Charleston and here we are. And from here, we're gonna do our lolly kicks and then our tuck turn to practice that hand in the center. Here's a second short pattern for practicing stretching away from a center point. So we're gonna do a couple underarm passes into some side passes, and we're gonna use our triple steps. So I'm focusing on this hand here, and we wanna keep an equal distance between us. So we're gonna do our underarm pass first, and that hand stays between us. And then as we switch to a side pass, same thing. I'm gonna watch that hand and try to keep it right in between us. Oh, we're switching to a butterfly. Same thing, keep that hand right in between as we go into the rock steps. And just one tip on that one, when you transition from the side pass to the butterfly, Brian's gonna make sure we do our side pass, and then when he comes around for the butterfly, he's actually gonna keep his elbow in a little bit, and then I'm gonna match the center point and not let myself get too far away, and that way when he goes up for this kick, I'm not too far out. Sometimes we see the follow, even if the leader says that he wants the center point here, we see sometimes the follow coming here, and then if he tries to lead the butterfly, it's a lot harder to stretch my arm out that far. Here's our pattern for elbow matching. Before we do the pattern, we're going to show one transition. We go from a crosshand Charleston side pass into a Charleston butterfly. Now for the butterfly, Brian's gonna want his right foot where normally he's using his left foot. So we're gonna do our side pass with the left foot rock for Brian, rock step, and here he's gonna go kick step, then a kick and kick. So instead of an extra kick step, he does a kick and kick to get on the right foot for the butterfly. We're gonna start here with two hands and we're gonna do our side to side. I think the best way to practice is to stay a little bit loose here. And then as we stretch away from each other, I'm gonna pay attention to Brian's elbows and match those as best I can. Okay, so here's our side to side. I'm gonna match those elbows and then we're gonna go into the boomerang since we already have two hands. And from here we're gonna do some 8-count Lindy Hop underarm passes. And out of the second one, we're gonna transition to 6-count Charleston passes. And this is our transitional. Brian goes from a left foot, he's gonna do an extra kick so he can go into our butterfly. And then from here, we're gonna end with a mini dip. Here's our pattern for practicing shoulder matching. And of course, you can practice your other matching principles in this pattern, but we're gonna focus really on shoulders for this one. So we'll start with the egos. Steve is gonna jump in front, and I get to match the shoulders, and same thing here. And then we're gonna do our triple swing and match the shoulders up and down. And from here, our 6-count send out, and I'm gonna match the position here. We're gonna go right into our sugar push, where we get a shoulder match here and a shoulder match on the turn. And then we're gonna switch to our little